This is a German violin, about 120 years old, made by Hopf, Hopf company. I got it on eBay for about 75 bucks. It had multiple cracks in the top of it, as you can see from the pictures, and a very large gash on the upper rib on the top, and as well as some cracks in the scroll. So I decided I'm going to try to fix it. And this is what the video shows. I took the top off and then put cleats and glued all the cracks. And the rest is fairly self-explanatory. I used tape over the cracks on the top of it before I removed the top so that the cracks didn't widen or get worse as I tried to pry the top off, because there was at least two or three very large cracks through the top. I love looking at the inside of these old violins because of all the mysteries that they might hold. Here you can see a lot of the cracks. This one, you could see that the bass bar on the top is actually part of the spruce of the top versus being glued in. I found that pretty cool. You'll see this pasty white type of glue that's all over the inside of it. It's been repaired before. There's the hole that I keep looking at because I don't know how the heck I'm going to fix that. The thing I found interesting is this was a really nice maple back that had been repaired once before. And here's another shot of that nasty hole in the side. Here's the back of it, and you can just see some of that beautiful flame maple. And again, these very odd pasty like glue that's throughout the inside of it. Here you can see I'm using clamps to glue the cleats down to stabilize the crack and prevent it from separating. These look big and clunky now, but they'll be sanded down and trimmed. This is the original repair in 1923, so it gives you an idea of how old this thing is. Probably from the 1890s. And here I'm using these homemade clamps to glue the top back together. And there's the bass bar that I was telling you about that's actually part of the top. And again, there's that hole in here. I put a patch on the inside, patch of maple that I heated and bent. And then I made an impression with aluminum foil of the hole so I could figure out how to cut that piece of bent maple that I made. And now I'm trying to see how I'm going to get that thing to fit in there. And my friend Bob Taylor helped me, gave me the idea to do that back patch on the inside, and otherwise I really wouldn't have known how to fix this. So there's the big hole, and then I'm gonna attempt to fill that with this maple patch. Unfortunately, I didn't have any nice flame maple, so it's a very different looking piece, but I'm not going for looks here. I'm really just trying to get the thing sealed up and hopefully see if it'll play. Here I'm clamping that piece in there very tightly and flush with the rest of the side, and it will be sanded down. There was some gaps, so I made some sawdust with glue and filled the gaps. I know it's not what a luthier would do, and but it kind of filled the gaps and made it a little nicer. Now I was going to put the top on back on, and I used hide glue, which is the classic way the luthiers used to build violins, because it's reversible glue. You can crack it open again and take the top off. Here I'm in the kitchen with all my homemade clamps right next to the stove. My wife is upstairs. She has no idea that I'm doing this in the kitchen, though I think she'd probably be okay with it. And here the top is finished and glued on. I took the clamps off after about 4 or 5 hours. This is a view through the the tailpiece hole, and I just love these views of violins and instruments from the inside. And here's the completed fiddle, and I got strings, threw it on, and a bridge just so happened to fit without much trim. There's a pretty maple back. There's a repair I did on the side. I think once the strings break in, it'll sound pretty good. Right now it sounds kind of warm and resonant, but it's just kind of get its voice back. So I'll be playing it quite often this week and see how it turns out. Thanks for watching.